Hello, check. All right, people, welcome to Catalysis by Vedantu. My name is Pahul, and we are back here again with the aldehydes and ketones chapter. So in the previous three classes of this chapter, three or four classes, we've already covered a lot of preparation reactions and a lot of reactions that start from the aldehydes and ketones. Now today's class is about more reactions of aldehydes and ketones. So we'll talk about a few reduction reactions and then a few oxidation reactions. So if I'm audible and visible, please write you in the chat box. You know the drill. Yes. And without any further delay, let's start the class. Chalo ji. So the first page over here tells us about two very, very important reactions. Ye jo reactions hai na, very important. Clemmensen's reduction and Wolff-Kishner reduction. And there is something very beautiful about these two reduction reactions. The first reaction that is there, Clemmensen's reduction, happens in the presence of a zinc amalgam. Okay, zinc is the main guy over there that helps us reduce the ketone. Okay, it happens in the presence of HCl. Okay, so there is zinc, there is some H positive, all right, there's Cl negative, and that is the entire thing. Now the mechanism of it is not very important for us right now. Mechanism is something that you can do a little bit of self-study on, but the main thing to note in Clemmensen's reduction is that it uses an acid. Okay, ye bahut zaruri hai yahan pe, that Clemmensen's reduction, which happens under a zinc amalgam, uses an acid. Okay, याद रखना, वील यूज दिस फैक्ट. एंड द Wolff-Kishner रिडक्शन ऑन द अदर हैंड यूज इज अ बेस. ओके, यू हैव दिस NH2 अलोंग विद अ बेस. सो दिस इज वॉट वी नीड टू रिमेंबर अबाउट Wolff-Kishner रिडक्शन, दैट दिस गाय यूज इज अ बेस. सो वॉट्स द काइंड ऑफ रिडक्शन दैट हैपन्स? योर कीटोन एसेंशली गेट्स रिड्यूस्ड टू एन एल्केन. सी, यू कैन इमेजिन दैट यू नो बोथ साइड्स आर getting satisfied by hydrogens alag alag se. Yeah, theek hai, got it, fine. So this carbon is losing the oxygen, getting two hydrogens in it, fine. So I hope you've written these reagents down: zinc mercury amalgam and NH2 with alcoholic KOH. Theek hai, ab what we'll do is we'll try to use these two reactions to do some questions. So today's class involves a lot of questions. So if there are any people who you know who are supposed to attend this class but not are not live right now, you can just share the information with them ki aaj apan sawal karne wale. Anyway, so people, let's do this question. Okay, what do we have? N2H4 in alcoholic KOH with heat. So my dear friends, over here in this particular structure, I'll draw a bigger image of it if you want. You have a benzene ring. Benzene ring is associated to another ketone. Yeah, so we have a ketonic part over here, and then we have a cyclohexane with an OH group. So over here the reaction is very simple. When I do my Wolff-Kishner reduction, what will I get as the product? Product bahut hi simple ban jayega. My ketone will be reduced to an alkane. So I will get something like this. Yeah. ये रिड्यूस हो गया कार्बन. इंस्टेड ऑफ द डबल बॉन्ड हो, नाउ वी जस्ट हैव एन एल्केन एंड द थिंग्स एट द बॉटम आर नॉट चेंज्ड. सो दिस इज प्रीटी सिंपल, नथिंग कॉम्प्लिकेटेड अबाउट इट. आई एम प्रीटी श्योर दिस वॉज ईजी. यू वर एबल टू डू दिस विदाउट एनी फर्दर थॉट. तो ये तो हो गया इसका ईजी पार्ट. नाउ देर इज अ ट्रिकी पार्ट दैट कम्स इन द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. ओके, बट द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन आई विल शो यू after I tell you about this piece of information, that at Vedantu we run full courses as well. Right now it's the lockdown, you can't join offline coachings. I'm pretty sure you know that. So if you want to join an online coaching, Vedantu has been teaching online for a very long time. It's a very good opportunity for you to join Vedantu as a full student. So you have the option of subscribing to the full course for 1 month, 3 months, 12 months, etc., etc. And if you subscribe for 12 months, the cost is as low as just 2500 per month, even lesser than that. I think kuch to tax wax mila ke it's somewhere around 2300 per month. Okay, so it's a very good deal. You will get all classes of all subjects. Like for J, you will get physics, chemistry, maths. For bio, for NEET, you will get physics, chemistry, bio. And the courses are available for all classes, 9, 10th, 11th, 12th, jis class mein bhi ho. If you want to join this course, please open the description box down below and these links will be there. You can check it out. All the details of the course are mentioned in that link. So just open it once and then see whether you want to join it or not. This is the discount code which will get you those really good prices. Chalo, so after this detail, let's get to this particular question. Do you realize the substrate is the same? बिल्कुल वही सबस्ट्रेट यूज किया अपन ने जो पहले क्वेश्चन में था. सो वॉट वी हैव ओवर हियर इज समथिंग लुक्स लाइक दिस. या बहुत ही सिंपल चीज है. कूल. एंड एट द बॉटम वी वंस अगेन हैव दिस साइक्लोहेक्सेनॉल सब्स्टिट्यूएंट. नाउ माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, नोटिस वी आर डूइंग क्लेमेंसन रिडक्शन. I'll just write CR for Clemmensen reduction. In Clemmensen reduction, we use the acid. My dear friends, do you remember this particular reaction? Ek reaction yaad karwata hu aapko. Do you remember this reaction? What happens? In the presence of an acid, alcohols get dehydrated. When you heat them up, you will essentially get an alkene, isn't it? I'm pretty sure all of you remember this reaction. Whenever you take alcohols in the presence of an acid and there is a little bit of heat present, alcohol will get reduced. Yes, this will turn into OH positive, yeah? Ye capture karega, this will become OH2 positive. It's a good leaving group. It'll leave carbocation formation and then eventually an alkene. So my dear friends, over here, do you realize that because there is an acidic presence, this particular OH will dehydrate? Yes, dehydrate ho jayega na ye. And now once it does dehydrate, what you will get at the end is a product that looks something like this. Ye to obviously this part will get reduced, Clemmensen reduction will happen, but along with that your alcohol would also leave to form an alkene. Ye alcohol bhi chala jayega yahan se and you will get an alkene. So, my dear friends, the thing is that this particular substrate contains an acid-sensitive part. Yes. Do you understand? Since the substrate itself contains an acid-sensitive part, we should not do Clemmensen reduction over here. Clemmensen reduction over here is not suitable. Because we ideally wanted to reduce only the carbonyl compound, but because of the presence of this acid satisfied part, we are getting some other compound altogether. ठीक है, अपन चाहते नहीं थे कि alcohol को कुछ हो, पर हो गया. Yes, so always remember that whenever the substrate has an acid sensitive part, Clemmensen reduction is not suitable. ठीक है, got it? काफी अच्छी चीज है ये. सो पीपल हु हैव जॉइंड लेट, प्लीज वॉच द क्लास फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग. ठीक है, चलो तो ये बात हो गई. नाउ लेट अस डू अनदर क्वेश्चन. लेट अस टेक दिस पर्टिकुलर सबस्ट्रेट, प्रिटी सिमिलर टू द इनिशियल वन. इट्स जस्ट दैट इंस्टेड ऑफ द ओएच देयर इज अ क्लोरीन ओवर हियर, या जिंक अमेलगम एंड एचसीएल. सो व्हाट विल हैपन इन दिस केस, द प्रोडक्ट दैट यू विल गेट विल सिंपली हैव द कीटोन पार्ट विल बी रिड्यूस्ड एंड द बॉटम पार्ट विल बी अनटच्ड. Right, the bottom part will be untouched, absolutely fine. So over here, this is my Clemmensen reduction once again, and the substrate does not have any acid sensitive part. Yeah, you know alkalalites do not really react with acids, fine. But now let me change the conditions slightly. Ab dekho aayega maza. Now things are becoming interesting. Let me draw the substrate over here once again in a bigger form factor. Double bond O, there's going to be this cyclohexane at the bottom with a chlorine, right? Now people, in my Wolff-Kishner reduction, I am using alcoholic KOH. I will remind you of one more reaction. Okay, do you remember this reaction? If we have an alkyl halide and we put it under alcoholic KOH, my dear friends, what reaction mechanism is this? This particular reaction is an E2 reaction mechanism. If you don't know about E1, E2, E1CB, we've done dedicated classes on E1, E2, E1CB, SN1, SN2 on this particular channel. So watch those videos if you don't know what E2 mechanism is. But for all of you who have studied these chapters earlier, you know this is an E2 reaction mechanism. So after elimination, what will be the product? You will get an alkene. So my dear friends, in this particular substrate, like the last to last example, we have something that will react bad with the reagent. The chlorine over here is a base sensitive part. Yes, base sensitive part, isn't it? So because this is base sensitive, when you do the Wolff-Kishner reduction over here, what will be the product? Of course, the ketone will be reduced to the alkane. That is obvious. But at the bottom, you will now have an elimination product as well. Yeah? So did you understand what I showed you? Clemmensen reduction contains acid. Don't use it with something that is acid sensitive. Wolff-Kishner reduction has a base. Don't use it with something that is base sensitive. हिंदी में भी बता देता हूं, क्लेमेंसन रिडक्शन में एसिड यूज करते हैं, तो उसको ऐसी किसी चीज के साथ मत रिएक्ट कर दो जिसमें पहले से ही एसिड सेंसिटिव ग्रुप प्रेजेंट हो. Wolff-Kishner में अपन बेस यूज करते हैं, तो उसे ऐसी किसी चीज के साथ मत रिएक्ट करो जहां पे बेस सेंसिटिव चीज प्रेजेंट है इन योर सबस्ट्रेट. ठीक है, गॉट इट? So this is the idea. Wolff-Kishner has a base. Don't use it with base sensitive substrate. Clemmensen has an acid. Don't use it with acid sensitive substrate. Fine. Chalo, isko main hata raha hu yahan se. In case you want to look at this explanation once again, you can just rewind the video and watch it again. You can pause the video anywhere you want. That's the advantage of having classes on YouTube. Theek hai? So awesome. Sriram is saying, sir, please English bro. If I say one sentence of Hindi, it doesn't kill the purity of the class. Every language is a language. We have all sorts of students over here. 99% of my class is in English. 1% I will use Hindi at times. Whatever I'm saying in Hindi, I'm repeating it in English as well. So don't worry. Okay? People who are going Hindi, English, English, Hindi in the chat box, please understand. Yeah? We can't satisfy everyone to 100% extent. So I'm trying to do the best that I can. I hope you guys can understand. Chalo. Anyway, so this was the idea behind Wolff-Kishner and Clemmensen reduction. These two. So I hope you've noted it down. We started with this in the beginning of the class itself. Very nice. And we've done some questions as well. Chalo. Now people, the next reaction that comes is a very interesting reaction. Now this reaction is typically used for esters. What is this reaction? Beauvault-Blanc reduction. It's a very fancy French name, okay? Beauvault-Blanc. Sounds like some French dessert or something. Yeah? So, it sounds like some French dessert. I feel like just going to France and ordering some, I don't know, Ratatouille with some Chardonnay or something, you know. Anyway, Beauvault-Blanc reduction. So what are the reagents being used over here? You use sodium in the presence of an alcohol, specifically an ethanol. Now, my dear friends, there are multiple types of reductions that use this particular reagent. There is one more reduction, which we will learn a little bit later. One more reduction is Birch reduction. Okay. I think you might have heard about Birch reduction in hydrocarbons chapter as well. We'll discuss this reduction someday in our regular classes. Birch reduction also uses the same reagent. Okay. But over here, this Beauvault-Blanc reduction that we are doing is typically done for esters. Typical for esters. So the original reaction, which is published in a paper called the Beauvault-Blanc reaction, is done for esters. So ye wala jo reaction hai na, ester in the presence of sodium and ethanol getting reduced to the alcohol. This is your basic Beauvault-Blanc reduction, but this reagent also works for aldehydes and ketones. Originally esters ke liye kaam aata hai, but iska reagent aisa hai ki ye ketone aur aldehyde ko bhi reduce kar deta hai. Alright, fine. So this is the basic scheme of things. If you have an aldehyde, it'll be reduced to an alcohol. If you have a ketone, that'll be also reduced to an alcohol. Aldehyde will give you 1 degree alcohol, ketone will give you a 2 degree alcohol. And ester will give you a 1 degree alcohol plus another alcohol that comes out of this guy. Yeah? Both types of alcohols will be produced, isn't it? Fine. Awesome. So now, my dear friends, let me give you an idea of the mechanism of this reaction, because that idea will also be used later in Birch reduction. In case you want to pause this page, you can pause it right now. Chalo. So let's try to think about the mechanism. See, what we are using over here is essentially sodium, and sodium likes to turn into Na positive, and it gives us one electron, isn't it? Yes, it gives us one electron. Now, whenever you have a species with a double bond O, let's just take an ester for convenience. Ester le lete hain. Whenever you have such a species, what can happen is this particular bond, this pi bond, can break apart homolytically. All right. Once it breaks apart homolytically, half the bond will go towards oxygen, half the bond will go towards carbon. Yeah, I hope you understand what arrows I'm making over here. These are fish hook arrows. They represent the movement of half an electron. I mean, half a bond, which means one electron movement. So homolytic cleavage is happening over here. Half the bond is going towards oxygen, half the bond is going towards carbon. And at the same time, since oxygen is, you know, quite an electron loving species, this oxygen can capture this electron as well. Or you can say the electron moves towards the oxygen, same thing. Yeah. So what you get as the first step in this reaction is something that looks like this. Oxygen, since it got one electron from here, one electron from here, it will have a negative charge. This was oxygen's own electron. This is an extra electron that we are giving to the oxygen. So this will carry a negative charge. The carbon over here that we have now has turned into a carbon free radical. Do you realize that? This guy has turned into a carbon free radical now. Isn't it? Because it captures only one electron. And then you have this OR over here, which right now is just sitting like that. Now, my dear friends, what can happen is you have your ETOH in the mixture. Ethyl alcohol. Very simply, this O negative can capture a proton from here. Fine, that can turn into OH. It's not of a huge significance for us. But this carbon is unstable. Yes, carbon wants to satisfy itself somehow or the other. So what will happen over here is to convert this free radical into a more stabler intermediate. Okay, you don't want a free radical. Free radical are very unstable. So this free radical just looks around and it sees that sodium is giving away electrons. It goes and captures one electron itself. This carbon is unstable. It's looking for some electron. You know that carbon free radicals want more electrons to complete their octet. The only place where it can see free electrons is sodium. It goes and captures one electron from sodium. So what you get after this step? What you get after this entire step is something that looks like this. OH, this guy, this carbon has turned into an O negative. Yeah, and this is your OR. Interesting, right? Yahan tak chamka kya ho raha hai? Kaafi lamba choda reaction mechanism hai. It takes a little bit of time to do this reaction mechanism, which is pretty interesting. Overall, what has happened is this bond broke apart homolytically. Both the oxygen and carbon captured one electron. Yahi hua na? Both the carbon and the oxygen captured one electron. And once the carbon has become negative, this guy can also react with the ETOH. Now, this also needs a hydrogen, yeah? It also needs the hydrogen. So after capturing the hydrogen, you have a species that looks like this. Chalo ji, badhiya. Yeah. Now, my dear friends, I'm pretty sure you realize this has become a hemiacetal. Remember, two classes back, we had discussed all about hydrates and esters and hydrates and hemiacetals and acetals. This species over here is simply a hemiacetal, right? And you know that hemiacetals are stable only under dry HCl conditions. When do we make acetals and hemiacetals? We make acetals and hemiacetals only under dry conditions, dry HCl conditions. So this hemiacetal will simply break apart, okay? This hemiacetal will simply break apart into the respective aldehyde plus this part will leave as the alcohol. Do you remember this particular mechanism? Do you remember hemiacetal formation? If you don't remember, we've done it two classes back. So the opposite of that happens. The hemiacetal just degenerates into the aldehyde and the alcohol. Ek bar is puri cheez ko dekh lo. Just look at this entire page. Okay, take 10-20 seconds to absorb the information that I've given to you right now. Very important information. Overall, agar main baat karun, it's a very simple mechanism. Homolytic cleavage, both of them capture an electron, both of them capture a hydrogen. And then hemiacetal turns into the aldehyde plus alcohol as usual. Okay, so drawing this entire scheme of things, okay, drawing that entire reaction mechanism in just a very small space, let me tell it to you how to do that so that all of you can understand it a little better. And pardon the horns on the back, you know I live next to a highway. Chalo, ye ho gaya. This breaks apart like this. This guy captures an electron from sodium. This guy captures an electron from sodium. Okay, this is just for imagination. This is just an overall scheme that I'm telling you so that you guys understand ki kitna simple mechanism hai. It's a very simple mechanism. Right? And this ends up capturing hydrogens from two alcohol molecules. Basically your ethyl alcohol that we have put in the reaction mixture itself. Yeah. This guy will capture one hydrogen. This guy will capture one hydrogen. And you will get a species that is your hemiacetal. Yeah. So that entire page condensed into just two steps. Simplified. Yeah. Very simple. Now this guy breaks apart into the aldehyde plus ROH. Okay, brilliant. So now we have to deal with the reduction of the aldehyde as well. So ester, one step of reduction causes aldehyde plus alcohol. Now we need to reduce this aldehyde as well. We'll be able to do it in just a matter of no time. बिना कोई टाइम लगाए, आई एम प्रिटी श्योर वी विल बी एबल टू डू इट. तो कैसे होगा दोस्तों? इज द डबल बॉन्ड ओ, ओके, फॉरगेट अबाउट द अल्कोहल, वी डोंट नीड टू वरी अबाउट इट, लेट्स जस्ट वरी अबाउट द एल्डिहाइड पार्ट. कैन यू इमेजिन द सेम थिंग हैपनिंग? कैन यू इमेजिन द सेम थिंग हैपनिंग? होमोलिटिक क्लीवेज ऑफ दिस बॉन्ड, होमोलिटिक क्लीवेज ऑफ दिस बॉन्ड. या दिस गाय कैप्चर्स एन इलेक्ट्रॉन, दिस गाय ऑल्सो कैप्चर्स एन इलेक्ट्रॉन. First thing that we get is essentially O negative, C negative. Again, use your ETOH. Again, use your ETOH. Capture the proton over here. Capture the proton over here. Finally, you got your alcohol. I know I spent 10 minutes on this particular mechanism. But this mechanism is very important because the same thing will be used in Birch reduction as well. Birch reduction is important. Sometimes direct questions come from Birch reduction in examinations. Bovold-Blanc reduction has also seen its applications in questions directly. So this mechanism is good to know. Kaafi simple ho gaya ab to. Bond breaks apart homolytically. Pehle oxygen captures the electron, captures a hydrogen. Then carbon captures the electron, captures a hydrogen. Becomes the alcohol. Fine. So my dear friends, once again going back to the page, do you understand the scheme right now? Ab scheme samajh aati hai sari? Why and how does sodium act as a reducing agent? Because it can provide an electron. Providing electrons to someone means I am reducing someone else. As simple as that. Okay, so aldehydes will be reduced to 1 degree alcohol, ketone will be reduced to 2 degree alcohol, ester will be reduced to 1 degree alcohol plus another alcohol that is present over here. Fine, and the entire mechanism that I showed you, this is a summary of that mechanism. So you can take a screenshot of this if you want. This is an excerpt that I've taken from Wikipedia. So you can just search for Bovard block reduction on Wikipedia, or you can just take a screenshot of this as well. I hope you've written whatever I taught you in the last 10 minutes, but in case you want to take a screenshot, you can take a screenshot right now. I'll give you 10 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Chalo, badhiya. Bovard block reduction, done. Now, my dear friends, we've done a lot of reduction mechanisms for aldehydes and ketones. Yeah, in my alcohols chapter, I hope you remember, we had covered lots of reduction reactions of aldehydes and ketones, because when you reduce aldehydes and ketones, you get alcohols. So we had seen the cases of reduction with LiLH4, with NaBH4. I have shown you an exception of LiLH4 as well in one question in Clemmensen reduction. So for all of you students who are new to Catalysis by Vedantu, welcome to the channel. My request to you is, if you have not studied organic chemistry previously, please watch the earlier classes that are there on the channel. You can see all the classes on the homepage and the playlist page of this channel. Okay? So, chalo. Now is the time for us to move from reductions to oxidation reactions. And I'm pretty sure you remember these as well, because we've seen these in alcohols chapter. When we oxidize alcohols, we get aldehydes and ketones. So all the chapters of organic chemistry are interrelated. Now, I would remind you, before we read the pieces of information that are there on this particular page, I would like to remind you of this basic reaction. Yeah, bilkul simple sa reaction, that if you have a 2 degree alcohol and if you put an oxidizing reagent like K2Cr2O7, yeah, or KMNO4, or CrO3 in acetic acid, yeah, potassium dichromate, potassium permanganate, and Jones reagent. If you use these, you will get an alcohol. This is a reaction that we've seen in the alcohol chapter already. I mean, alcohol will get oxidized to a ketone. This is a reaction that we've seen in alcohol chapter already. But now is the time for us to look at these reactions. These are very important for us. काफी इंपॉर्टेंट रिएक्शंस हैं ये, बिकॉज माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, दीज रिएक्शंस आर यूज्ड इन द लेबोरेटरी. ओके, दीज रिएक्शंस आर यूज्ड इन द लेबोरेटरी. व्हाई? लेट अस सी. दिस इज अ कीटोन, माय डियर फ्रेंड, सॉरी, दिस इज एन एल्डिहाइड, एंड यू ऑल नो दैट द हाइड्रोजन ऑफ दिस एल्डिहाइड इज ऑक्सीडाइजेबल. रिमेंबर, when we were oxidizing 1 degree alcohols, I showed you all the oxidizable hydrogens. So this hydrogen that is here is oxidizable in nature. So once you oxidize that hydrogen, you will get an acid, H carbonado OH. So when that hydrogen is oxidized, it becomes an OH group. Theek hai? Bala Umay Singh, sir, Bovard block reductions reagent is also used in amines in Mendius reduction. Yes, yes. Absolutely. Mendius reduction naam ka ek reduction hota hai in the amines chapter. Over there as well you use sodium and alcohol. Absolutely correct. Chalo. To ye aa gaya laboratory mein karne ka kaam. Why so? Because my dear friends, these reactions happen only with aldehydes. Okay? These reactions happen only with aldehydes, not with ketones. Okay? Because ketones don't have this oxidizable hydrogen, these oxidizing agents are simple good oxidizing agents. They can't oxidize ketones anymore, so they oxidize the aldehyde, and this is the product that they form. Yeah, Tollens reagent, Fehling's solution, Benedict solution, they all will give you the acetate ion, RCOO negative. in the Tollens reagent, you will get a precipitation of silver in the laboratory. It looks very beautiful. So when you do this Tollens test in the laboratory, you know what happens? You take a test tube and you put your solution that has the aldehyde in it, and then you put a Tollens reagent. I'll tell you what Tollens reagent is. And you shake it. After you shake it for a little time, then you see a very beautiful film of silver gets formed around the test tube. If some of you have done this reaction in the laboratory, you would know. So, aisa hai ki the entire outer section of the test tube starts looking a very beautiful silver color. So, that is called the silver mirror test. Okay, very beautiful silver mirror sa ban jata side pe. Okay, then if you use Fehling solution, Cu2O gets precipitated. So Fehling's and Benedict solutions are pretty similar. I'll show you what those are. So in both of these cases, you have the precipitation of the copper's oxide, which is brick red in color. So when you do this reaction, the entire test tube becomes really dirty brick red kind of a color. So you know that yes, we had an aldehyde initially. Then further reactions, if you reacted with Ag2O moist, once again there is a precipitation of silver. Wo silver sa fir se aa jayega aapke paas. And if you use NaOCl, okay, you will once again get RCOOH and NaCl. So my dear friends, please write these reactions down. I'll give you 10 seconds to take a screenshot or pause the video and write all of it down. And then we will see the details of Tollens, Fehling's and Benedict solutions. So ye likh lo please. Cool. Likh liya. Shriniketan is saying, did I miss a class on Wednesday? No. You didn't miss a class on Wednesday. I couldn't take a class on Wednesday because I wasn't feeling fine. Shriniti is saying, do we have to memorize all of this? Shriniti, I hope you understand that the products are pretty much the same in all of the cases. The only thing that you have to memorize is the different reagents. And once you do multiple questions from the chapter of aldehydes and ketones, these reagents will come in front of you time and time again. You will automatically remember them. Theek hai? So don't worry about that. Chalo, now let us look at what is Tollens reagent. Tollens reagent, my dear friends, is a very simple solution which is known as ammoniacal AgNO3. What is it? We take AgNO3 in ammonia and water. What is NH4OH? I hope you understand. When we put ammonia into water, you get NH4OH. And if any people, I mean, if any one of you has been to a chemistry's laboratory, and if you've by chance, smelled the NH4OH solution, I'm pretty sure you know what depression smells like. Yeah? Samarth is saying, sir, 11 chemical bonding class 11 kab aayegi? Samarth aa rahi hai aur chali bhi jayengi. Hum chemical bonding class karte hain Tuesday, Thursday aur Saturday 7 baje. To hum 4-5 lecture kar chuke hain uske. Subscribe kar lo channel ko to pata lagta rahega, theek hai? So my dear friends, if you guys have smelled this solution, you know what anxiety and depression smells like. It smells very bad, okay? If you smell NH4OH solution, your throat will hurt for the next 3 days. It's a very, very strong smell. In fact, you know, it's such a strong smell that it actually causes your brain to start flowing blood faster in your body. Kaafi ek excitement si ho jaati hai. It helps you release adrenaline as well. So have you seen those bodybuilders and weightlifters jo bada bada ekdam weight uthate hain mast? Yeah, so those people in their competitions, they use this tiny little pellet. If you've seen competitions, you might know. So there's this tiny little pellet. When they break it apart, it's called an ammonia pellet essentially. So when they break it apart, it gives you a pungent smell of ammonia, and that just charges them up, and then they lift a very heavy weight. So yeah, the smell is so extreme that your body just starts to react to it in a very dramatic manner. Kabhi galti se smell karke dekhna, maza aayega. Okay, don't inhale it just dur se. You stand like 2-3 feet away from it, you'll realize what I'm trying to say.
Anyway, so AgNO3 plus NH4OH gives you AgNH3 whole twice positive. Very important piece of information. Sometimes they ask you this directly. What happens when you put AgNO3 in ammonia? You get AgNH3 whole twice with a positive sign. This will be one of the answers. Direct questions comes in organic chemistry. Okay, what happens when you put AgNO3 or AgCl in NH4OH? AgNH3 whole twice positive gets formed. Okay, you get NO3 negative on the side, H2 on the side. So eventually, this AgNH3 whole twice, this complex that we have with silver, okay, diamine complex of silver, that is what it is called, silver diamine. So when you have this complex with silver, this ends up reacting. Okay, there is some OH negative, ends up reacting, and you get your acetate ion. You will get your silver, which forms the silver mirror. Ammonia will get liberated, and water was always there. So yeah, a little bit of more water is getting formed. So you don't need to remember the entire reaction, okay? Two things that you have to remember are AgNH3 whole twice is formed, diamine silver complex is formed, and you get a silver mirror. These are the main two things that you need to remember. Baki to kya ho raha hai? Aldehyde is getting oxidized to an acetate ion. That was always expected. Theek hai? So toluene's reagent is selective. It does not attack olefinic bonds. What are olefinic bonds? Olefinic bonds are C double bond C. Okay, so if you have, let's say, this type of a reagent where you have a C double bond C with the aldehyde part, toluene's reagent will not touch this guy. The aldehyde will be oxidized. Coffee simple. So in this entire page, two things to remember, in fact. AgNH3 hole twice, and it forms a silver mirror after oxidizing the aldehyde. Just two things to remember. Okay, chalo badhiya. Shriniketan, yes, thank you. I will take care of myself. I'll try as best as I can, bro. Thank you so much. Chalo, next case is Fehling's test. Okay, next case is Fehling's test. So Fehling's test comprises of two different solutions. Fehling solution A is CuSO4.5H2O. It is also known as blue vitriol. My dear friends, what are vitriols? I'll tell you what vitriols are. Vitriol is a general term used for metallic sulfate solution. Okay, it is a general word used for metallic sulfate solution. Okay, so if you have the sulfate of some other metal, let's say MgSO4, if you dissolve it in water, it'll be some kind of a vitriol. And vitriols are generally colored in nature. So CuSO4.5H2O is known as blue vitriol. Okay, essentially not a solution. I shouldn't call it a solution. I should call it metallic sulfate, which is hydrated. So you see CuSO4.5H2O. So whenever you have metallic sulfates that are hydrated, you call them vitriols. That's the general idea of vitriols. You can search on Wikipedia for more examples of vitriols. Okay? So that is the first solution of Fehling, blue vitriol. Second Fehling solution is known as Rochelle's salt, also known as sodium potassium tartarate. Rochelle's salt, sodium potassium tartarate. This piece of information is very important. A lot of times in NEET and JEE mains, this question is asked directly. Seedha pooch lete hain. Which of the following components is a part of Fehling solution? 3-4 complicated names will be given. One of the names will be sodium potassium tartarate. This is what it is. So my dear friends, the thing that you see, the organic part, is the ion of tartaric acid. Okay, ye jo cheez aapko dikh rahi hai. This particular thing is known as tartaric acid. And I'm spending a little more time on these pages so that you can absorb all the information carefully. It helps you remember if you've seen things with your eyes. Isn't it? Chalo. So when you take tartaric acid, convert it into the respective carboxylate ion, one part is satisfied by potassium, one part by sodium. Sodium, potassium, tartarate. Okay, so reaction kya hai wahi? Simple cheez hai. The aldehyde is reacting with copper, 5OH negative. You are getting copper's oxide, which will give you the brown precipitate. And this was expected, yeah? Aldehyde will get oxidized to the respective acetate ion.
Maje ho gaye bhaiya.
Very nice. Good. अमर इज सिंह सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड इज विट्रियोल. हाँ भाई, तो बेसिकली जो भी वेन एवर वी से ब्लू विट्रियोल और रेड विट्रियोल और ग्रीन विट्रियोल एटसेट्रा, दोज आर एसेंशियली दीज हाइड्रेटेड मेटल सॉल्ट्स ऑफ सल्फेट्स. ठीक है, दैट इज अ नॉमेनक्लेचर दैट वी यूज फॉर दीज एज वेल. ठीक है, विट्रियोल रेफर्स टू अ सल्फेट एसेंशियली. चलो, ये भी हो गया, बढ़िया. I hope you've written this down. If you need more time on this page, pause it and watch it. I'm going to Benedict's reagent now. So Benedict's reagent is the same, pretty much the same as your Felling solution. Felling solution A is CuSO4.5H2O. The same is applicable for Benedict's solution. Okay. The second thing which is written Felling over here shouldn't be called Felling. This is your solution B for Benedict's reagent, sodium citrate. Do you see, the entire thing is pretty much the same in Felling's and Benedict. In Felling's, you are using a tartarate. In Benedict, you are using a citrate. So instead of tartaric acid, you are using a derivative of citric acid over here. Okay? So this is what citric acid looks like. What is citric acid? Citric acid is a tricarboxylic acid. ठीक है, सिट्रिक एसिड हैज थ्री कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड्स इन इट. तो ये जो बनाया ना यहां पे बीच में, ये दिस गाय इज द आयन ऑफ सिट्रिक एसिड. सो यू हैव अ सोडियम सिट्रेट इन द बेनेडिक्ट्स रिएजेंट इंस्टेड ऑफ सोडियम पोटेशियम टार्ट्रेट इन द फेलिंग सॉल्यूशन. प्रीटी मच द सेम रिएक्शन, सेम मैकेनिज्म, सेम प्रोडक्ट. यू विल गेट कॉपर, ब्रिक रेड कॉपर प्रेसिपिटेट विल बी फॉर्म्ड. सेम थिंग, इज जस्ट दैट द एसिड यूज्ड ओवर हियर इज अ लिटिल डिफरेंट. ठीक है, तो when you combine these two together, you will get your CO2 positive that will react with OH negative plus the aldehyde. You will get your acid ka ion, acetate ion, plus you will get CO2O, which once again will be a brick red precipitate. गंदा सा एक लाल कलर का precipitate बन जाएगा. Fine. So my dear friends, once again, this piece of information is very important. Felling solution and Benedict solution are relatively mild reagents compared to Tollens reagent. Thus, it does not oxidize aromatic aldehydes unless there is an electron withdrawing group at the ortho or para position. I'll show you an example of this. Tollens reagent is very strong. It will reduce all sorts of aldehydes. Benedict solution and Felling solution can reduce simple aldehydes. They can reduce aromatic aldehydes only if there is an electron withdrawing group at the ortho or para positions. Let's see this. Theek hai? So what does this mean? This means that this is the aldehyde that you have. Ye mast ekdam dikh raha hoga aapko. There is an electron withdrawing or donating group present at the bottom. So if we have Tollens reagent is going to show you a Tollens test with all these aldehydes. In sub aldehydes ke saath aapko Tollens reagent ka test dikhega hi dikhega. But with Felling's and Benedict solutions, things are a little different. Which of these cases are electron withdrawing groups, people? This is an electron withdrawing group. And NO2 is an electron withdrawing group, yes. So in the cases of electron withdrawing groups, you will see Felling's and Benedict test as well. In the other cases, nothing. So aromatic aldehydes show you Tollens test for sure, but Felling's and Benedict solutions do not give this test. So this is an advantage of Tollens test, that it is easier to detect all sorts of aldehydes using Tollens test. Okay, but there is one drawback of Tollens test as well. I'll tell you a little while later. अरे वो पेज कहाँ चला गया, ठीक है समझ आ गया ना. फेलिंग और बेनेडिक्ट में ओनली इलेक्ट्रॉन विड्रॉइंग रिएजेंट्स विल शो यू द टेस्ट. ओके सो वन ड्रॉबैक दैट आई विल शो यू अबाउट टॉलेंस रिएजेंट. ओके द वन ड्रॉबैक दैट आई विल टेल यू अबाउट टॉलेंस रिएजेंट इज दैट टॉलेंस रिएजेंट ऑल्सो शोज अ टेस्ट विद टर्मिनल एल्काइन्स. ओके दिस इज समथिंग दैट यू नीड टू रिमेंबर. Tollens test also shows a positive test. Okay, if you take a terminal alkyne kaisa hota hai? C triple bond C with one end having hydrogen. This end could be anything. It could be hydrogen, it could be an alkyl chain. But if one end of the C triple bond C ends with hydrogen, Tollens reagent will react with this and give you a silver mirror. Okay, so terminal alkynes also give you Tollens test. Now, my dear friends, why does this happen? This is something that you have to find out on your own. This is a part of self-study for you guys. ठीक है? Got it? So, ये आप खुद से खोज के लाना. Try to figure out why this happens. Okay? One more thing is, special case of alpha hydroxy ketones. What are alpha hydroxy ketones? Something like this. Okay? So, you just make a ketone. On the alpha carbon, you put an OH group. So, alpha hydroxy ketones will also give a test with Tollens, Fehling's or Benedict solution because this OH can be oxidized to a double bond O. Okay? So, not only aldehydes will give you Tollens, Fehling's and Benedict test, alpha hydroxy ketones will also give you Tollens, Fehling's and Benedict test because this is the product that can be formed. Okay? ठीक है? So, if this R dash is a hydrogen, of course, that will also be oxidized to the OH group. So, just write this piece of information down. This piece of information will be useful for us when we are studying the chapter of biomolecules. Biomolecules mein, glucose, fructose, all of these basic sugars are alpha hydroxy aldehydes or alpha hydroxy ketones. So, all my basic sugars like glucose and fructose, they give us a test with Tollens, Fehling's and Benedict solution. So, alpha hydroxy ketones and aldehydes will give a test with all of them. Tollens, however, can also reduce these terminal alkynes. I mean, oxidize these terminal alkynes. ठीक है? चलो, ये भी हो गया. Very nice. Akash is asking, are the lectures on YouTube enough for JE Advanced? Yes, bro, I'm teaching all pieces of information over here as well. ठीक है? चलो जी. अमर क्या बोले जा रहा भाई, दोबारा से अपनी इन्फॉर्मेशन चेक कर ले एक बारी. ठीक है, अमोनियाकल AgNO3 विल गिव यू अ पॉजिटिव टेस्ट विद टर्मिनल एल्काइन्स, रिमेंबर. ठीक है, टर्मिनल एल्काइन्स के साथ. चलो बढ़िया. एजिल व्हाट्सअप विबग्योर द स्काई इज सेइंग टेल योर शेड्यूल. माय शेड्यूल इज दैट ऑन मंडे, वेंसडे एंड फ्राइडे एट 7 PM वी डू क्लासेस फॉर 12th क्लास स्टूडेंट्स. ऑन Tuesdays, Thursdays and Saturdays at 7 PM we do classes for 11th class students, and at 8:30 PM Monday to Friday we do classes for 2020 aspirants. ठीक है, चलो जी. Okay, let's move on. Now, my dear friends, for the next 10 minutes that are remaining in this class, the next 10 to 15 minutes, we are supposed to do a lot of questions. Are you ready? चलो अब सवाल करते हैं. सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन ओवर हियर इज दिस सबस्ट्रेट. विल टेक द सेम सबस्ट्रेट एंड विल डू मल्टीपल रिएक्शंस विद इट. ओके, सो वी आर टेकिंग हॉट अल्कलाइन KMnO4. हॉट अल्कलाइन KMnO4 इज अ वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट. सो इट इज गोइंग टू ऑक्सीडाइज द एल्डिहाइड टू एन एसिड. इट इज गोइंग टू ऑक्सीडाइज द OH टू अ डबल बॉन्ड. डू यू रियलाइज इट विल ऑल्सो ब्रेक अपार्ट द ओलेफिनिक बॉन्ड. ये तीनों को ऑक्सीडाइज कर देगा हॉट अल्कलाइन KMnO4. सो माई डियर फ्रेंड्स, वॉट विल हैपन ओवर हियर इज, लेट्स ट्राई टू मेक द प्रोडक्ट. ओके, तो यहां से शुरू करेंगे प्रोडक्ट. सो हाउ मेनी, चलो बना के देखते हैं, ठीक है. आई विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम दिस कार्बन. ये बन गया इधर ऐसा OH ग्रुप, डबल बॉन्ड O, फाइन. सो दिस पार्ट विल बी ऑक्सीडाइज टू द एसिड. दिस OH ग्रुप दैट वी हैव ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर कार्बन will be converted to a double bond O. Now, this part, the double bond, will break apart. Yes, double bond O, single bond OH. Oxidative ozonolysis kind of a reaction. We've already done oxidative ozonolysis earlier. Please revise that if you've forgotten about it. Aur yahan pe kya ban jayega? Yeah. Now, this guy, as you know, will once again oxidize further to convert into CO2 plus H2O. Yes, so this will be the product that you get with hot alkaline KMnO4. Olefinic bond oxidized, OH oxidized, aldehyde oxidized. Okay, very nice. Chalo, aage badhte hain. Pyridinium chlorochromate. Now, this is a mild oxidizing agent. It's not as strong as KMnO4. Pyridinium chlorochromate will not touch the aldehyde. PCC does not touch the aldehyde. It will not touch the olefinic bond either. It will touch only the alcoholic part. PCC's job is to convert alcohols to aldehydes or ketones if they can do so, if they can go. ठीक है. इफ यू हैव अ 3 degree अल्कोहल, नथिंग विल हैपन विद पीसीसी. बट पीसीसी कैन टेक 1 degree अल्कोहल टू एल्डिहाइड, 2 degree अल्कोहल टू कीटोन. सो द प्रोडक्ट दैट यू विल फॉर्म ओवर हियर इज गोन बी दिस गाय, राइट. ओनली द अल्कोहल पार्ट विल बी ऑक्सीडाइज टू अ कीटोन यूजिंग पिरिडेनियम क्लोरोक्रोमेट. ऑलराइट, लेट्स गो फॉरवर्ड माई डियर फ्रेंड्स. K2Cr2O7 इन एच पॉजिटिव, strong oxidizing agent. Yes, it's going to take the aldehyde and oxidize it to the acid. It is going to take the alcohol and also oxidize it to the respective ketone. So the final product that you will get over here will be, yes, double bond O, single bond OH, and you will also get a double bond O over here. Fine. So K2Cr2O7, remember, it is a strong acid, is going to oxidize everything that it can. चलो अगला क्वेश्चन करते हैं. कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड अल्कलाइन KMnO4 विद अ कीटोन, हे, हाउ कैन वी ऑक्सीडाइज अ कीटोन? बट सिंस आई हैव फॉर्म्ड अ क्वेश्चन ओवर हियर, वी हैव टू डू समथिंग विद इट, इजंट इट? तो कीटोन देखते हैं कैसा है. यहां पे दिस इज द कीटोन एंड आई एम गोइंग टू रिएक्ट दिस विद कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड अल्कलाइन KMnO4. सम पीपल विल से सर नो रिएक्शन विल हैपन, बट लेट मी टेल यू, रिएक्शन विल हैपन. How will the reaction happen? My dear friends, if you remember ketoenol tautomerization, yaad hai? Do you remember ketoenol tautomerization reaction? Do you remember ketoenol tautomerization reaction? So let's take a simple ketone. Let me show you how the reaction will happen with that. This is the ketone. You all know that a little bit of the ketone will exist as the enol form. Yes. Isn't it? Now, people, do you realize that KMnO4 can break this apart? Yeah? KMnO4 can break this double bond apart. Olefinic double bond toot sakta na? Yes. So finally, what will be the product that you get? You will get something like this, which will further get oxidized to CO2 plus H2O. Yeah. And over here, what will you get? You will get your OH and double bond O. So, very strong oxidizing agents like concentrated alkaline KMnO4, concentrated acidic KMnO4, concentrated acidic K2Cr2O7, they can oxidize ketones as well. Just turn the ketone into respective enol part and break it. Very interesting, very important reaction of breaking ketones into smaller components. Okay? So my dear friends, can you do this reaction please? Can you do this reaction? Chalo, let's have a little more fun. This is going to be a do it yourself reaction. Agli class mein bataunga iska answer mein. Theek hai? This answer I will reveal in the next class. So when is the next class? There are more questions that we have to do, by the way. There are 2-3 more questions. But the answer to this question I will reveal in Monday's class. Monday at 7 p.m. when that is when the next class is. This answer will be revealed then. सोच के देखना कौन सा की टोन बन सकता है यहां पे, विच की टोन विल बी मेजर, विच की टोन विल बी माइनर, व्हाट विल बी द प्रोडक्ट्स. सोच के देखना. या आई मीन विच इनॉल विल बी मेजर. यू कैन फॉर्म एन इनॉल ऑन दैट साइड, यू कैन फॉर्म एन इनॉल ऑन दिस साइड. थिंक इट इज अल्कलाइन KMnO4. इट्स अ नाइस क्वेश्चन. डू इट योरसेल्फ. आई विल रिवील द आंसर इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास, दैट इज ऑन मंडे एट 7. चलो लेट्स डू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड एसिडिक K2Cr2O7. So once again, concentrated, very good oxidizing agent. Let's convert this into the enol form. The ketone can get converted to this particular enol form. And this double bond can be broken apart by K2Cr2O7. Yes. So the final product that you will get, the final product that you will get will be, ye hoga. Double bond O and OH over here will also get formed. Yes, this is the carboxylic acid that you will get. Fine. So a carboxylic acid which has 2 carboxylic acids on it, 6 carbons overall. This is the reaction that will happen with concentrated acidic K2Cr2O7. Very nice. Agla question dekhte hain. What will happen when this guy reacts with Tollens reagent? My dear friends, in this initial substrate that I have given you, one part is a ketone, one part is an aldehyde. Tollens reagent does not give any test with ketones, it gives a test only with aldehydes. So the aldehyde part will be oxidized, ketone part will be untouched. So finally the product that you will get will look something like this. Double bond O and the aldehyde part will be oxidized to an acid. Yeah, so the substrate is a little confusing. You might not notice that one of the parts is a ketone, one of the parts is an aldehyde. Only the aldehyde will be oxidized by the Tollens reagent, not the ketone. Very nice. Yes, kafi sahi hai ye. Badhiya, mazedar. Now I think the last question of the class is this one. What happens when I oxidize this jazz, same substrate, one aldehyde, one ketone, with K2Cr2O7 in H positive? Again, we are heating it, acidic K2Cr2O7. This is a strong oxidizing agent. It is definitely going to oxidize the aldehyde, but the ketone part can also be oxidized, yes. So my dear friends, what we need to do is we need to make the enol form of this structure. Enol form banate hain zara ek second. Double bond O, single bond H, ye aisa hi raha. And over here, the enol form will look something like this. Isn't it? It'll actually be a good enol form because ye enol form kafi achha hoga, because you can actually have some sort of a hydrogen bonding over there as well. A little bit will be possible. Chalo, theek. Anyway, the enol form, as usual, this can be broken apart. So what will be the product? The product will be the aldehyde part gets reduced. The aldehyde part gets oxidized to the acid. The ketone part will also get oxidized to the acid. And ये छोटी सी चीज का क्या निकल आएगा साइड पे? CO2 plus H2O. Very nice. ये भी बन गया. Okay. So my dear friends, do you remember the name of this acid? किसी को नाम याद है इस acid का? So this particular acid is known as the phthalic acid. This is how it is spelled. PhThalic acid. ठीक है, काफी अच्छा रिएक्शन. थैलिक एसिड इज गेटिंग फॉर्म्ड, CO2 plus H2 इज ऑल्सो गेटिंग फॉर्म्ड. सम ऑफ यू मस्ट बी वंडरिंग, सर वाई डजंट K2Cr2O7 ब्रेक अपार्ट दीज बॉन्ड्स, बिकॉज दोज आर एरोमैटिक इन नेचर. दिस एंटायर रिंग इज एरोमैटिक इन नेचर एंड इट्स नॉट वेरी इजी टू ऑक्सीडाइज एरोमैटिक स्पीशीज. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू ऑक्सीडाइज एरोमैटिक स्पीशीज यू विल हैव टू इंक्रीज द प्रेशर एंड टेम्परेचर अ लॉट. ओके, सो दैट हैपन्स इन वेरी रेयर कंडीशन. इफ नथिंग इज मैंशनड यू सिंपली हैव टू ऑक्सीडाइज द अदर थिंग्स, डोंट टच द एरोमैटिक रिंग. ठीक है, तो एरोमैटिक को अपन टच नहीं करेंगे. चलो जी, बढ़िया, दिस वॉज अ गुड रिएक्शन, नाइस. सो माई डियर फ्रेंड्स, टूडेज क्लास इज ओवर. आई एम प्रिटी श्योर यू एंजॉयड द क्वेश्चन दैट वी सॉल्व इन टूडेज क्लास. वी लुक्ड एट अ फ्यू रिडक्शन रिएक्शन. द रिडक्शन रिएक्शन वर क्लेमेंसन, वुल्फ किशनर. वुल्फ किशनर वॉज बेसिक, क्लेमेंसन वॉज एसिडिक इन नेचर. देन वी सॉ बोवर ब्लॉन्क रिडक्शन. द सेम रिएजेंट फाइंड इट्स एप्लीकेशन इन बर्च रिडक्शन, in Mendius reduction as well, sodium in ethanol. We saw exactly how Bowers-Blanc reduction happens, and then we saw different reagents like Tollens reagent, Felling solution, Benedict solution, Ag2O in moist conditions, and NaOCl, and all of those gave a very good reaction with aldehydes. Tollens reagent is faster, it is stronger. Fellings and Benedict solutions are not that strong. So Tollens reagent, ammoniacal AgNO3, gives a test with aldehydes, alpha hydroxy ketones and terminal alkynes as well. Yeah, and in case of aromatic aldehydes, Fellings and Benedict don't give you a test unless there is an electron withdrawing group present on the respective aldehyde. What will electron withdrawing group do? It will increase the reactivity of the aldehyde. You remember in the first class we discussed that reactivity of aldehydes is increased when you have electron withdrawing groups on it. That is why Benedict and Fellings can react with electron withdrawing group aromatic aldehydes. Finally, we did some questions. We saw how ketones can get oxidized to further smaller acids because the double bond in them can break apart when you make the enol form. And finally, my dear friends, in case you think your preparation needs a lot more boost, then you can join Vedantu as a full long-term student. The subscription for the full course at Vedantu is available for 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, 12 months. And if you subscribe to the 12-month course, it is very cheap. It's somewhere around 2300, 2400 per month with taxes. Okay? So in case you want to enroll, this is the link. It's in the description box. This is the coupon code. It's also again in the description box. Apart from that, for all of you students who are new to the channel, who've attended this class for the very first time, let me tell you the schedule. For 11th class students, we do classes on Tuesday, Thursday and Saturday at 7 p.m. For 12th class students, which was today as well, we do classes on Monday, Wednesday and Friday at 7 p.m. And for all of you students who are targeting 2020 examination specifically, we do classes for you guys from Monday to Friday at 8:30 p.m. Okay? So Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday and Friday at 8:30 p.m. we do classes for 2020 targeting students. And these days we are solving the NT Abhyas mock test series for NEET and JEE both. Cool? Badhiya? धीरज भाई, कक्षा खत्म हो चुकी है, आप जा सकते हैं. जरूरी नहीं है आप सब कुछ सुन के जाएं. हमें भी पैसा कमाना है, हमें भी खाना खाना, तो ये चीज़ें ज़रूरी हैं. जो लोग समझदार हैं वो लोग समझते हैं. सो हरी सिंह, ऑसम सेशन, आई एम ग्लैड यू एंजॉयड द सेशन मैन. चलो, श्रीनिधि सिंह, वोंट कीटो इनॉल एग्जिस्ट इन बेंजाल्डिहाइड केस ऑफ द सेकेंड क्वेश्चन. श्रीनिधि, द एल्डिहाइड पार्ट विल नॉट शो अ good keto, I mean enol over there, you can see that. Okay, for enolization you need an sp3 hybridized carbon at the alpha position. That's not present over there, so benzaldehyde doesn't show any enol form. Okay, acetophenone shows the enol form, so wo apan ne oxidize kar hi diya tha. Cool. So Shank is saying, so plan of action for 2020 aspirants, I have completed both the playlists from the channel and I prefer to solve the NT papers offline, currently following the schedule. That's absolutely fine Shashank, not a problem at all bro, bilkul sahi hai ye. Yeah, Pranati, thank you so much, I am glad you enjoy. Anju, I am glad you are enjoying. Anil, don't worry man, you can watch the class from the beginning, it's going to be on YouTube all the time. Theek hai. JEE paper solving, Nathu, we are going to start that from Monday. ठीक है। जेके व्लॉग्स थैंक यू सो मच ब्रो। जस्सी विरे थैंक यू सो मच। चलो बढ़िया। विरूपाक्षी थैंक यू सो मच, आई एम ग्लैड यू आर एंजॉइंग। करुणा थैंक यू थैंक यू थैंक यू। चलो जी शिवा ग्लैड। नयन आई एम फाइन ब्रो, बढ़िया है, चल रहा है। चलो दैट्स इट फॉर टुडेज क्लास पीपल, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर ज्वाइनिंग इन। इफ देर आर एनी मोर क्वेरीज दैट यू हैव, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू आस्क मी, लीव अ कॉमेंट डाउन बिलो लेटर। एंड या दैट्स इट, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर ज्वाइनिंग। लाइक कर देना अगर वीडियो मजा आया तो, इफ यू एंजॉयड द वीडियो हिट द लाइक बटन, स्टे सब्सक्राइब टू द चैनल, आई विल सी यू वेरी सून।